everybody. Welcome to Cornerstone. My name is Alyssa. I am one of the worship directors here, and it is my pleasure to welcome the University Choir and Orchestra from Jessup University, which I just graduated from Jessup this past spring and got to be a part of this group for 3 years. It was the best 3 years. It feels like I'm bringing my home from Jessup home to Cornerstone. So without further ado, Tom, take it away.
Yeah. it is really great to be here. It is really great to be here. Let me tell you something. You have scored with Alyssa. That is fantastic. You are lucky to have this young woman. She was grew into such a prominent leader while at Jessup, and it was just so it was just such a joy to just be able to watch that happen and to see you mature. And now it's the same thing is happening with Caitlin here. So it's just really, really fantastic. Do you have any more daughters? That's it? Okay, all right. We are from Rockland, just up the road. And so we are a fairly small Christian liberal arts university. And so we have lots of different majors. If you have any students that are looking at schools, please consider us. I think we might have a program of study that might interest them. And this is the University Choir and Orchestra. So they're quite active bunch. This is our first of two tours that we'll do this year. And so this is our first day. We were in Vacaville earlier today, working as at Buckingham Charter Academy. Did I say it right, Emma? Collegiate Charter. It was very collegiate. So we had a good time with them, and then we came down here, and this is going to be a fun night. Hannah, you ready for this? I think you are. This is Hannah Milam and Milam. Is Milam? Are you sure?
Yes.
Milam. I thought it was Milam. How did I say it last week?
You said Milam.
I said Milam?
Yeah, you did.
I think you're wrong. You go by Milam?
It's Milo.
Okay. All right. Well, lead us into a gospel tune. It's called God Surprised Me.
Power, God surprised me with His love. Just when I thought my case was hopeless, He sent an answer from above. God surprised me with His mercy. God surprised me with His love. Just when I thought my case was hopeless, He sent an answer from above. When He's
done,
His promise for you
more.
When He's done, His promise for you
more.
No matter the trial,
our
God is able.
just the attitude that you bring to that song, and you just take us to church, and then you come down and you're just gonna play the lovely cello. It's such a juxtaposition. Oh man, so we have been doing this song, it's called Plead For Us. We've been doing it for the year, and it doesn't make every concert, but I think I've been thinking about it, and I think maybe it ought to, because I think the message is so strong, and it's really, the premise is Christ at the throne pleading for us. Pleading on our behalf. Have you thought of it in that way? I think so often we think of it as, you know, it's God the Father and Christ and the Holy Spirit, and they're up there, and we're, you know, hopefully we'll get past the jury. And you know what? It's good to remember that Christ is on that jury as a ringer for us, on our behalf. So this is called Plead For Us.
Oh,
Well, I think you know this young lady. Her name is Caitlin. I think you four generate the amount, you generate noise of six roads. Do you do that at church? You do it at church too? Well, that's awesome. That's great. So you guys moved to Florida. What part?
Pensacola,
Florida. Very cool. I hear that's nice this time of year. It is? Okay. What are the gas prices? Less than $3. It's okay. Do it. It's all right. We'll be okay. Paying over $5 a gallon. Caitlin, how are you, young lady?
I'm doing very well.
Yeah,
thank you.
You are. So Caitlin is a member of Crossroads, and she is digital communication, art, and design. And you're just you're doing all the things.
Yes. That's all of them.
And and do you love it?
Yes, it's amazing. I love Jessup.
You do. And if you were to just summarize Jessup in your life, it's been 2 years. Well, maybe actually a year and a half, right? How would you summarize it?
The Lord works in mysterious ways, and He has really worked in my life by bringing me to Jessup. And Jessup is just an amazing community of people with amazing professors who genuinely care about you. And like being in this group is just, it's truly such a blessing.
That's great. You're a blessing to us. Speak then.
In the great name of Jesus, there's power. In the great name of our God, there is peace. And when we call the name of Jesus, we claim our victory. In the great name of Jesus, we're free. Thank you.
Jesus, we are standing in the presence of our God, and in this holy place we see for all eternity that in the great name of Jesus we're free.
Thanksgiving is like? Yeah? Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. Hey, I have a fun song, and I learned how to pronounce it correctly on the ride with my Russian friend here. Tell me if this is right. Tell me if this is what we practiced. Gospodi pomiluj. Did I do it right?
It's getting better.
All right. It's getting better. I'm not quite there yet. This is Masterpieces from the Russian Liturgy. It's actually Hospodi Pomiluj is the phrase. It's Lord have mercy on us. And so they are going to ask it. They are going to plead. They are going to beg. They are going to do everything in between. In fact, they will utter this phrase 75 times.
Hospodi pomiluj, 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 Hospodi
stop goofing around, and we'll sing a few more out here for you. And in the meantime, Eliana, can you, why don't you grab a solo microphone? And we've got new stuff out there that they could buy, right?
Yes, we have some new mugs and some hoodies, as well as long sleeve tees, and our new albums that we just recorded at Skywalker.
That's fantastic. And I saw some of these new tumblers, and man, are they sharp looking.
They are.
Did you pick them out? Did you order them?
I believe Lauren did.
Oh, Lauren.
She's got
did.
An eye for color.
Lauren's over here, and Lauren and Totem. He is our mascot, but also a service animal. So if you want to pet him, you have to ask. And I abuse that so much. So he is Emma's companion. Now I'm just starting to talk about Totem. He is just the goodest boy ever. Merch. Sorry about that, Eliana. We have some new t-shirts, and right? And we have some new coffee mugs. So they should get those.
Yes, Yes, you should.
They really ought to.
Please come visit us, or if you just want to talk to us, we're very friendly and would love to talk to you. So.
I think a bus costs about $3,000 a day, and we are in hotels, I think, two nights, right? They're in hotels two nights, and so that's about, what, $2,000 a night? Way more, about $3,000. So anyways, that merch, those CDs, those recordings, not only gives you an opportunity to take these guys home with you, they recorded those about, what, a month ago? But also, you know, you can sip your beverages all day long with them to help us out. So what do you guys want to do? What song do you want to do? Well, we got Set Me as a Seal. You don't want to do that one?
Yes.
Tara likes it. Why don't we do that one? This is Renee Clausen. He arranged one of my favorite songs. It's an arrangement of a Shaker melody, and it's Tis a Gift. And we've done that before, but he also did this one. He is a wonderful composer and arranger. It's called Set Me as a Seal. So how's everybody doing out here? Everybody good? Good. Anybody want me to move anyone? If you don't like who's standing next to you? You want me to, I can do that? No? Okay, I guess we're good. Tara, what is your major? Music and theater. And Eliana, what's your major? Visual and fine arts. And we know what Caitlin's major is. Hey, Jaden, what's your major?
Theater.
I didn't know that. Great. Isaac? Business. Very cool. Very cool. Nate, what about you?
Business and marketing.
Any nursing majors in here? Oh, we have one. Her name is Leigh over there. If you fall down, bump your head. Yep. Are you a nurse?
No.
Oh. Oh. Okay.
I'm married to William Jessup, and she's been here.
Oh, wonderful. That's fantastic. That's fantastic. Let's see. Any psychology majors in here? No, we don't. We lost our psychologists? I thought we had at least one or two. We don't? Oh, she graduated? Oh, man. Who are we going to talk to on the bus? Me? Oh, heck no. Oh, man. This is called Deep Water. It's a song that we recorded this year. You know, we've done it. I think I first discovered this song about 10, maybe 12 years ago. And I have this name written at the top, and this has been my copy that I've used. Every 2 or 3 years, we pull it out. And the name I have up here is Brittany Atwood. You remember Brittany? And Brittany walked with a walker, and she was very difficult to move around, and she would struggle getting from place to place, and she would come by my office maybe once or twice a week, and she would just speak words of encouragement to me. Little Brittany Atwood. Brittany had a rough time, and when I found this song, I thought, this is Brittany Atwood, because it's describing her. It's describing the peace that she has in her life. And some of the words, for every soul that knows deep water, though rain and waves may never cease, for every soul that knows deep water, where Christ dwells, there is peace. And Brittany was just a living example of those words. So Brittany, wherever you are, we're going to do it one more time for you.
Thank you.
your granddaughter's name?
Brooke.
She was? What's her last name? Wow. Do we know a Brooke?
We do.
You do?
Yeah.
Well, she can tell you all about your granddaughter. How come I don't know Brooke? You do advancement events? Yeah, you do. You know, I wouldn't be able to do what we do without this young lady. Her name is Lauren Horst, and she's the operations manager. Yeah. I mean, I literally go where they point me to go, and we start waving our arms, and they do what they do, and we all stop at the same time. And then everything that happens after that is you. You figure out how to get it done. I don't know how you do it. Hey, Alyssa, where are you? Oh, there you are. What are you doing back there?
I'm running the lighting and the live stream.
Oh, what, there's a live stream. Should we do Almighty God?
Yes. Yeah. I don't think I can say no with my parents saying yes over there.
I didn't know you guys liked Almighty God. You do? Okay, well, here's Almighty God.
It's a fan favorite.
Oh.
With rain.
Melissa, go, go, go.
What do you think so far? I don't think I could be more proud sitting in the tech booth and getting to watch and listen as this so many people who I got to sing in choir with and so many new faces that just making beautiful music and worship to the Lord and being able to sing in the back on Almighty God, because that's the one that I know, is really incredible. At this time, I would love it if you guys would consider helping the cause of Jessup Music by giving financially. This is a joy offering, it's a love offering for the group so that they can keep doing things like this. So the way that we can do that, we have our cute little joy boxes. They're red right there, and then one's right by the door. You can give there anything in there right now. We'll go to Jessup Music. And I'm looking at you, Marlene, on this one. Okay, good. But we would love to support what Jessup is doing and what these incredible young men and women are doing in the choir and in the orchestra. So can we just pray over that right now? Awesome. Lord, we thank you that we get to come before you and worship you with such beautiful music, such expertly crafted music. Lord, you love when our hearts are generous towards you and when we give generously. So Lord, I pray that you will multiply whatever is given, that a dollar will become $5 in the hands of Jessup Music today, that they would be able to reach so many people that need to hear your good news and your love through their music. Lord, we thank you. We bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
ready for Christmas concerts at Jessup, and that is the first weekend of December, right? First, second, and third. So I think we can, we're going to do a concert on Friday night, two on Saturday, one on Sunday afternoon, right? And so if you are interested in attending any of those, it's going to be fantastic. It'll be a lot of fun. I think we have about 2,000 people come through the doors over four shows. So I would love to have you. And Eliana, right here in the middle, go talk to her. She can help you navigate the interworkings of the web, as they say, and help you get a ticket. Right? You'll help them with that? Is it difficult? It's easy? Okay, so if your phone has a hinge on it, you might need help to do that. The hinges are coming back? Oh, I didn't know that. Well, congratulations if you do have a phone with a hinge on it. I guess you're adopting new technology now. Oh, little town of Bethlehem. I know we just did little town. We're going to do another one to celebrate that town. Did you know we were doing two songs about the town? Well, it's a great town, so I had to do it. And this one features our wonderful oboist. Is that how you say it? Oboist? Her name is Mary, and she is fantastic on that instrument. And we just recorded this about a month ago. told our God? I forgot. Oh, it was Grace, and was it Justin? Come on down, you guys. Grace Harmon. Grace Harmon is a teacher ed major, and you're going to be doing, we talked about this in the spring, you're doing your, what do you call it?
Student teaching,
where you're in the classroom and kind of getting your feet wet. You're going to do third grade?
Yeah, maybe third or fourth.
I think I said this last week. We were talking to Maya, and you said third grade. I said third grade was my favorite grade. Mrs. Johnson, she was fantastic. And then what I didn't say, fourth grade, hated it. I did. I don't know why. At fourth grade, we did those dumb missions. Do you remember those? Did you have to do those? Those stupid sugar cubes would not stick. So maddening. You want to drive a fourth grader nuts, give him a box of sugar cubes and a tube of Elmo's glue, or Elmer's wood glue. It wouldn't work. And it didn't look anything like a mission. And you know what they have now? They have kits that you can just put together. What is up with that? Kits? If I had to struggle with the sugar, raise your hand if you had to build a sugar cube dumb. See? And look, they don't look happy, do they? So I think you ought to go for third grade. That's the point of all that. This is called Behold Our God. It was introduced to us last spring, and we just kind of kept it, and we recorded it about a month ago. This is on one of those. And it can become quite a powerful worship song. So this is Grace and Justin.
Who has held the oceans in his hand? Who has numbered every grain of sand? Kings and nations tremble at his voice. All creation rises to rejoice.
Behold our God, seated on his throne. Come, let us adore him. Behold our King, nothing can compare. Come, let us adore.
Let us adore him. Behold.
You know what I realized? I don't think I introduced Justin. Did I introduce you? No, I got stuck on that stupid mission in fourth grade. Man, that dumb thing. Mission, I tell you, building those missions, that's for the birds, I'll tell you that much. Justin, you are studying what, my friend?
Music.
Music, and this is your senior year?
Yes.
And let's see, you are a vocalist, and I've seen you play the bass, mm-hmm. and you do all this commercial music stuff?
Yeah, but I'm doing the worship part, actually. That's my
You're doing the worship art specialization?
Yes.
Pretty cool. That's Justin Canis. Is it Canis or
Canis?
Oh man! I'll wait till I introduce this guy, Stefan Grimminstein.
You want to give it one more try?
Grimminstein.
Wait, what was that?
Grimminstein. Steen.
I think someone in our family line was like illiterate.
Again, are you sure that it's Steen?
I'm positive. I don't know if my ancestors were though. Right. Because that should definitely be pronounced Stein.
Okay. Eric, what do you think? You do? Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
That's a first.
All right. And then who is this distinguished fellow standing up here?
I'm Christopher Nance.
You, Christopher. Your parents are here to support you. Did you know that?
Did you realize that
they were here?
Yeah, I looked down and they were right in the front row. It's awesome.
Excellent. So I said, whose parents are going to be here? And he raised his hand. I said, wait a second, Christopher, where is your family from? He said, Florida. And I didn't realize that you guys had moved. So these guys win the contest of traveling the farthest to get here. So are you ready?
I hope so.
Okay, don't mess up.
I won't.
There's no need to cry. Stand up on your feet now. Lift your head up high. Don't wait till tomorrow to lay down your sorrow. Freedom is here today. Wipe away those tears, child. Put down your shame. Oh, I see an empty grave. I hear the heaven breaking. Angels. Somebody celebrate, I see an empty grave. Wipe away those tears, child, there's no need to cry. Stand up on your feet now, lift your head up high. Don't wait for tomorrow, lay down your sorrows. Wipe away those tears, child. Put down your shadow. I see an empty grave. I hear the heavens waking, angels in jubilation. That stone's been rolled away. I hear the heart is breaking. I bet the devil's shaking. Somebody celebrate, I see an empty grave.
Lay those tears, child, go and tell the news. What started in the garden, finished in the tomb. It's all reversed, the apple.
get that? Did you record that?
Yes.
Good, 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 good. Oh, boy. Chris and Marcus, where's Marcus? Oh, you're way over here. So Chris and Marcus are both in going into aviation, which is very, very cool. Tell me about the aviation degree. You get 4 years, you come out of it, what, you got to go to flight school or something?
4 years, you get your private pilot license, your instrument rating, and your commercial rating. So you can basically start with absolutely nothing, and you come out being ready to get paid to fly. And then you get a reduced amount of time necessary to become like an airline pilot or an air freight pilot.
So they don't have to train you as much because you know so much coming in, right?
They teach it really, really well.
They teach it really, really well. So if you see either one of these two guys in the cockpit of a plane that you get on, just say, especially him, I remember when you sang Empty Grid. And that was awesome. Yeah. Now, please fly this plane correctly. So this is Jaden Santini. Yep. You brought some friends, Jaden.
I guess.
Yeah. This is going to be our last song, and I think it's great to end with this song. It's called Favorite Song of All, and it really is a beautiful premise. And the premise is God's artistry is all around us. It's everywhere we see, the sunsets, the sunrise, the mountains, the lakes, everything is as if God was or is an artist. But his real joy comes from, and his favorite song of all is those of the redeemed when they claim him. And so Jaden's going to tell you about that, called Favorite Song of All.
He loves to hear the wind sing as it whistles through the pines on mountain peaks. Loves to hear the raindrops as they splash to the ground in their magic melody. And he smiles in sweet approval as the waves crash to the rocks in their harmony. All creation joined in unity to sing to him majestic symphony. But his favorite song of all is the song of the redeemed, when lost sinners now make a leap, lift their voices loud and strong, when those purchased by his blood lift to him a song of love. So pleasing to his ear as his favorite song of all. And he loves to hear the angels as they sing, holy, holy is the Lamb.
Holy, holy, holy is the Lamb.
Heaven's choirs in harmony lift up praises to the great I am. Begins to sing, and a million angels listen as a newborn soul sings, I have been redeemed, I've been redeemed.
That's his favorite song of all.
That's his favorite song of all.
It's the song of the redeemed.
When lost sinners now make leap, their voices loud and strong, when those purchased by his blood lift to him that song of love. Nothing more he'd rather hear, not so pleasing to his ear, as his favorite song of all. It's not melodies and harmonies that capture his attention. It's not just clever lines and phrases. No, but when any heart's set free, washing blood on Calvary begins to sing. Oh, begins to sing.
For Jessup Music.
Dang, that song always gets me every time.
Now, Tom, I know you gotta have one more in ya. No, you have to. You have to have one more in you. We cannot end it here. Let's see, what do we got next?
Eh?
Yeah.
Thank you.